I was supposed to be vlogging my reading of this book, and I really meant to, but like, that just wasn't going to happen over the last couple weeks. So instead, I'm just gonna film a chatty little vlog style, off the cuff discussion of it now that I've finished. Rosie here. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here to talk about Accidentally Engaged by Farrah Heron. This is a contemporary romance novel that I read for Book Buffet because romance, and especially contemporary romance, is not a genre that I have read much before. And let's chat about it, I guess. This is also very highly recommended. My co-hosts Emrita and Kim both absolutely loved this book and had nothing but good things to say about it. So because it was so like well loved and well promoted to me, I guess, I was both excited and also a little bit nervous. I know it's weird and I know we've been over this so many times, but I always am when I read a super hyped up book. I'm always a bit like, ooh, but is it actually gonna be good? Will I agree with it? And I totally did, as always. I guess let's back up a little and I'll introduce the premise. So as I said, it's a contemporary romance set in Canada, and our main character is a Muslim Canadian who's in her, I think, early 30s. Basically, she's trying to like get out from under her family's influence. She loves them, she wants them in her life, but like she doesn't want to work for the family business and marry someone they set her up with and have her parents meddling in everything she does. So she's living on her own, she's had a string of failed relationships. She doesn't like her job, but she doesn't want to say that because then her parents will like try and force her to go into the family business and real estate development. And basically, she's not at a great place in her life. Then she meets an absolutely amazing man who's just moved into her apartment building, and she's like, oh my god, this guy's incredible. He seems so great. He's smart, he's funny, he's kind, he's interesting, and he's the guy her parents are trying to set her up with now. Of course, she's like, well, if my parents want me to get with this guy, I obviously can't. Even though she's super attracted to him because he seems really great, she's vehemently insisting that she's not going to marry this man. And then a cooking competition comes up, and she needs to compete with family, so she and this guy decide to pretend to be engaged on TV while actively not being engaged around family. I thought that part of the book was going to be a bit like, eh, really? The sort of premise that, like, okay, what's this cooking competition where she needs a fiance? But the way they write it in, it actually makes total sense, and I wasn't bothered by that at all. Anyway, it's a contemporary romance. You guys know where this is going. And it was fantastic. I think I said that already. Who knows? It was a really, really fun read. I really enjoyed it. I really liked that it wasn't just about this couple and their romance. Like, that's obviously the main story. This is definitely a romance novel. But I really liked that it was also about Rena's relationship with her family and like her growing in her relationship with her parents and with her sister and sort of confronting things that they'd all been not talking about and moving forward and coming together closer. Also about her figuring out who she is and what she wants to do. She doesn't like her job and then she's laid off and she really wants to cook, but she doesn't know in what format. And I feel like there's real growth and discovery there as well. I loved her friends, and I realized after I finished it that there's actually another book that this author has written about one of her friends, and I have to go read that now because seriously, everyone in this book was just incredible, and it actually made me really miss seeing people. I'm a very introverted person, but after, you know, many, many months, over a year of really basically no social interactions, I'm starting to feel the "it would be really nice to talk to people" feeling. And this book definitely strengthened that because her friend group and like her relationship with her friends is just so fantastic, and I miss seeing people and need to get on that. I liked this book in general. I thought the plot and the romance and like what was driving things forward, all of that really made sense to me. If you guys remember back in February of this year, I did a try three video where I read three historical romances. I'll link it up here. One of the things I struggled with a bit was just that, like, everything felt very implausible. This is not to criticize historical romance or people who like it. Different strokes for different folks, right? But for me, I found the way the story developed in this made a lot more sense to me. I related it I related to it a lot more. I thought it was going to be the opposite and that contemporary romance was going to be too weird because they're modern people with cell phones and stuff, but actually I loved the contemporary element. I thought the way everything developed was just fantastic. It felt within the realm of what people do and how people behave. Obviously it's a novel, obviously it's a romance novel, but for all of that, it did feel like these were real characters, and I really appreciated that. This book is Fade to Black. I figured out why I didn't like the spicy romance novels that I read in February. I don't want the spicy scenes intermixed with the plot. I found this worked really well. It definitely alludes to the fact that there is spiciness going on. It definitely, you know, doesn't shy away from that. But I personally want to either be reading the spicy side or the actual story side. And I'm probably not going to talk about it in my wrap-ups or anything because, you know, some things should stay private, at least for me. But I've been reading a bit of erotica this month as well, and I'm liking the erotica, and I'm liking the Fade to Black romance, but what I think I don't like is when I'm sitting on the couch in, like, I'm reading a book mode, and all of a sudden it's spicy. I want to either be like, right, I'm sitting down to read something spicy, or just allude to it. I don't know, maybe this is a weird preference. I feel like it is, but hey, now that I know what I like, I think that will help me look for the type of romance books that I want to read, maybe, because this one has been such a success that I definitely want to read more. Flat out, this was so much fun. Also, it's so funny. I think this one, I don't think it's a rom-com. I think it is a romance, but like, there is some genuinely funny writing in this. There were laugh out loud scenes and lines in this, and some of the stuff and the way it was written was just so hilarious, and I absolutely loved that. What else? Oh my goodness. The food was amazing. I should talk about that since this is a book buffet vlog. The food descriptions were fantastic, and oh my god, did this book make me want to eat. I loved that the food was actually involved in the story. Maybe this is the case in all food-themed romances, but like, the development of the cooking and the cooking competition and stuff actually were involved with the romance, not just a backdrop. I don't know if that's usual or not, because again, it's not my usual genre, but it was really cool. There was also an interesting point raised once or twice that I'm not going to weigh in on either side, but I think it's an interesting discussion that I'd be interested to see more about, was preserving these people's traditional foods, I guess you could say, or like their family recipes and their cultural foods, and not bending to westernize them. So as part of this cooking competition, it's mentioned a few times that Rina and her fake fiance, actual boyfriend, whatever you want to call it, are cooking the foods the way they ate them growing up, not trying to fusion them. And it's clear that they're not saying that there's no place for fusion, but this is a home cooking competition and they're celebrating their home cooking. They're not gonna make a curried shepherd's pie. They're gonna make the curry the way their mom made it. And that was an interesting conversation, and I could have stood to see more of it discussed here. And also, I'd be interested in seeing, like, I don't know, I'm sure there's a good New Yorker article or, like, you know what I mean, something like that discussing that topic. And I kind of want to look into that more now. I really haven't filmed very much for this, but I don't have that much more to say. This was a delightful little read. I absolutely loved it. And if you haven't read it yet, I'm adding my recommendation to the pile, and you definitely should. Let me know down below, is this a genre you read much of? And if it is, what should I read next? Because I need to try more funny Fade to Black contemporary romances. This is what I need in my life. So let me know what you've got, and if you like this video, please give it a like down below. If you would like to see more of my videos, please hit subscribe, and thank you for watching.